Hello, my name is Alex Schulman. I am the author of the novel The Overlevenden. I am so happy that it has been published in the Netherlands and the Flanders. And my publisher has received a lot of questions from you, the readers, and I can't answer all of them, but here are some of the answers. Thank you so much for reading my book. Okay, we have a question from Naomi Bloomberg. What inspired you to write this story, and what elements are from your own life? Well, 5 years ago, my mother died, and I remember when me and my two brothers, we met up in her apartment the day before her funeral, in order to see if there were things there that we could take home with us to remember her by. And we were walking around our mother's apartment, and all of a sudden my bigger brother yelled from the bedroom. He found a note, an envelope, where it said, "To my sons if I die." And it was like a note from the other side, from our dead mother. And we sat down on the bedside, on our mother's bed, and we read it. And it was like, I think it was the strongest moment of my life in a way. And a couple of years after this, I realized that thing, that envelope, that discovery could actually be a nice frame for a fiction story. So the whole frame for the story is based on what happened to me. And almost every element in the book is also based on my childhood. So I would say that a lot of things comes from my life. Here's a question from Cindy Vanarvegen. How did you decide on the structure? Did you start with everything already planned ahead? Yes, I planned everything ahead. I could never like just start to write and then see where it takes me. I need to be very strict in the structure. And the structure, it's two stories, two storylines, one in the present time and one in the 80s, 90s. And the present time structure is told backwards. So the first chapter is from 12 o'clock at night, and three brothers are sitting in the outside their summer cottage of their childhood, and they have an urn, and they're crying, they're bloody, they're all wet, and a police car comes down to this house. And then I hope that you ask yourself, what happened? Why are they crying? Why are they bleeding? And then the next chapter is from 2 hours earlier, when they're fighting. And then hopefully a reader will ask themselves, why are they fighting? And that's the structure of it. I go backwards for one day. At the same time, the childhood storyline goes chronological. And in the end of the book, the two stories meet in the last chapter. And I'm obsessed with the storytelling, with structure, how to create the best story. And I spend maybe 75% of my time thinking about those things. So I'm very happy that I could find this structure of this book. Here is a question from Marjolaine Palvast. I'm sorry if I pronounced the names wrong. The question is, what part of the book was written first, the beginning or a scene from the middle? I wrote the book exactly in the way it appears in the book. So I also wrote it backwards. And that was because I needed to be in the same place, in the story as a reader would be, in order to see if it all works out. It was a big hassle. It was like a dream coming true. You know, when I was a kid, I dreamt of, I think many do maybe, dreaming about being an author and dreaming about having a project where you have these post-it signs on the walls and you change and you swap places and you write and you're like a crazy scientist. And for the first time in my career, I could finally do it. I had these post-it signs everywhere, and it was like a big structure. And then I just followed the structure of the post-its and I wrote it in the computer. Here's a question from Nils Dingemanse. What made you write a novel after your autobiographical books? I have two answers. The first one is that I was so tired of being afraid of the reactions from different parts of my family. I was always a bit sad when people that I'm close to reacted in a bad way over the books I wrote about my mother or my father. And I wanted to be free from that. And also, storytelling wise, since I am very interested in how to tell a story, if you write autobiographical, then you have to relate to the truth. You have to be honest, right? And the truth is not always the best story. So I wanted to be free in that way also. I wanted to tell a story in exactly the way I wanted to tell it. So it was like a project of making myself free as a writer. And I'm very happy that I took the step. It was a bit scary, but I think it went all right. Okay, last question. Marlos Van Zon writes, perhaps the most important question of all, are you writing a new book? I want to read more. That's so kind of you, Marlos. Yes, I am. I'm actually sitting right now. Here's my desk over there. On Gotland, an island in the Baltic Sea, and I'm writing the next novel. I have done maybe 35% of it, and well, I hope it's gonna be. I hope it's gonna be good. As an author, you're very up and down. Yesterday, I thought it was the most brilliant piece of artistry ever made, and today when I woke up and I read through what I wrote yesterday, I was so embarrassed that I wanted to shut down the whole project. But I think that I will finish this book during the fall, and it will come, hopefully, if my publishers at the Bezige Bay will like it next fall in the Netherlands and the Flanders. Okay, thank you so much for listening, and thank you again for reading. I hope so much to go to the Netherlands after the summer. My publisher says that it might happen, and I would love to go and see you all. Thanks so much.